Hi viewers, welcome to LMS Solution. Today we are going to see about solar PV and battery powered water pumping system using DC motor. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. So this is the model created for solar PV and battery powered water pumping system using DC motor. This system consists of solar panel. So here you can see that solar panel rating is, the single panel rating is 248.97 watts, voltage at maximum power point is 30.7 volt, and current at maximum power point is 8.11 amps. Here we are using two parallel string. So this is the IV and PV characteristics of the considered PV array. The maximum power at 1000 watts per meter square is 498 watts. So this maximum power going to be vary depends upon irradiation. So here we design on boost converter. That means the load, right? So this is going to be act as a load, the DC motor. This DC motor going to be act as a water pumping system. The rating of DC motor is 359 watts. The terminal voltage is 96 volt. So I am going to design this boost converter. The input voltage is 30.7 volt. The output voltage is equal to 96 volt, and then the input power is 498 watts. So based upon this PV power, input voltage and output voltage, so here we need to decide the value for inductor and capacitor. So next, here we are used neural network MPPT. So here you can see that the neural network MPPT receiving two inputs. So one is irradiation, another one is temperature. So based upon irradiation and temperature, the neural network when we decide the reference voltage for extracting the maximum power from the PV panel. This reference voltage going to be compared with the PV voltage. After that we are getting error voltage. This error voltage going to be processed via PI controller. This PI controller will be generate the duty cycle. This duty cycle going to be processed via PWM generator. So this PWM generator control this IGBT in order to extract the maximum power from the PV panel depending upon this irradiation and the temperature. So next we are going to see about the battery system arrangement. So here I am going to explain the rating of the battery. So here we are using lithium-ion battery. The nominal voltage is 48 volt. The rated capacity of this battery is 48 Ah. Initial state of charge is 50%. So here I am going to design the bidirectional DC to DC converter. So based upon the voltage 48 volt, the output voltage requirement is 96 volt, and then I am going to use the same rating, right, 498 watts from the PV panel. So 498 watts. Okay, so based upon this 498 watts, 48 volt and 96 volt output, here we need to decide the inductor value and the capacitor value. Okay. And then this converter, right, the bidirectional converter, they have two switches, right, this S1 and S2. This is going to be controlled by means of voltage controller. So here we need to measure the DC bus voltage. or converter output voltage, and it going to be combined with reference voltage. Here we will get error voltage. This error voltage process via PI controller. The output of PI controller is duty cycle. So this is going to be process via PWM generator. The output of PWM generator is pulse, PWM pulse. This pulse going to be control this two IGBT switch in order to maintain the voltage across this converter. That should be follow this reference voltage. So this is the model of that solar PV and battery powered water pumping system using DC motor. Now I am going to explain the simulation result of this model. So here I am going to vary the irradiation from 1000 watts per meter square to 800, and then 600, and then 400 for every 2.5 seconds. And here we are measuring the PV and converter details. That means in this scope we are going to measure PV power, converter power, PV voltage and converter voltage. So here you can see that in this scope we are measuring the battery voltage, battery current and the SOC of the battery. So this is battery voltage, this is battery current, and SOC of the battery. So in this scope we are measuring the speed of the DC motor, torque of the DC motor and the armature current of the DC motor. And here we are measuring PV power, converter power and then battery power. And then DC motor power. Now I am going to simulate this model and explain the simulation results. So here you can see that the maximum power is around 498, right? And then here you can see that the converter power, and this is battery power. Battery power in negative. What's the meaning, right? And the battery, now battery is in charging mode. So here you can see that the SOC of the battery is keep on increasing, because battery reading from 0 to 2.5 seconds, the irradiation of the solar PV is 1000 watts per meter square. So that's why we are getting around 498 watts. Already I told that the DC motor power is 359 watts, right? So 359, the remaining power, 498 minus 359, and the remaining power used to for charge the battery during that time 0 to 2.5, because during that time 0 to 2.5 seconds, the irradiation is 1000 watts per meter square. So after 2.5 seconds, you can see here, right? After 2.5 seconds, the PV power is comes to 400 watts, right? Here the motor power is 359. So here also you can see that battery charging mode, but the charging rate is very less, right, when compared to previous instant. That means from 0 to 2.5 second. So here you can see the slope, right? But here you can see the slope, both slope having a different slope, right? That means during this time period from 0 to 2.5 it having higher rate of charging, but from 2.5 to 5 second the rate of charging is very less, right, when compared to 0 to 2.5 seconds. So this is because of the power availability from the PV power is reducing because of reducing irradiation. And also you can see here, right, from 5 seconds to 7.5 seconds the PV power comes to around 300 watts, right? Here you can see that the DC motor power is 359. So, but we are getting only 300 watts from that PV panel, right? The remaining power will be taken from the battery in order to supply the DC motor. Okay. So, based upon this PV power availability, battery going for charging mode. So, here you can see that from 0 to 2.5 seconds, battery in charging mode condition. From 5 to 10 seconds, the battery going for discharging mode. Okay. And also you can see that the voltage, right, voltage is maintained around 97 volt. It's track the and the reference speed, the reference voltage command in the DC to DC bidirectional converter. So here you can see this is PV voltage, this is converter power and PV power. So here you can see that the speed of the DC motor is maintained constant always with the changing irradiation condition also. Whatever the irradiation condition, the speed of the machine is DC machine is maintained constant, and also you can see that the torque of the machine always constant and the armature current of the machine always constant. So because the load power is going to be shared between solar PV as well as battery, so based upon the irradiation condition. So this is the working of solar PV and battery powered water pumping system using DC motor. Thanks for watching our videos. Kindly subscribe our channel and also click bell icon for notification about upcoming videos. Thank you so much.